big old circles. Try to go up and over. Be nice and tall. And when you're ready, take it back. Good. And then one over the other. And a little twist. In. And we'll stay on the left foot. We're gonna lift the right leg up, rotate out. You can toe tap down to regain balance each time. Try to get it up nice and high and really push it back behind you. Get one more, and then we're gonna go the other direction. Good, one more. Nice, and shake it out, go to the other side, take it back. Nice, good, and then forward again. Good, last one. Good, shake it out. We'll do some good morning. So pushing those hips back and then bring them all the way forward. And then we'll kind of go side to side each time, bringing the hips to full extension at the top, kind of squeezing those glutes. And then we'll go back to straight back and forward, side to side and forward. Good. Even that out. Last one. We'll go straight back. And then just into a forward fold. So try to bring the palms down towards the ground. And walk the hands side to side. Stretch out those hammies and the low back. And then let's walk the hands forward into a down dog position. Pushing those hips up towards the ceiling. And then we're going to come forward, step up wide onto one side, and then push back and switch. Kind of try to open up the hip when you're in that sort of lunge position. Good, last one. Okay, so we'll do two rounds to warm up. We're gonna do three plank walkouts. So we're gonna start in the plank position. Be mindful trying to keep the hips level. So start with your chest right over the palms, and then we're gonna walk out as far as you can, keeping those abs tight, and then walk it back. So that's just three times out and back. And then you're gonna drop down to your forearms. And then you're going to start in the forearm plank position, place one elbow in the palm and press yourself all the way up, come back down, and then switch. So six total, three per side, and then six per side, reverse lunge to front kick. So I'm going to stay on one side, lunge it back, and then push through that forward foot and kick that other foot out in front six times on each side. And then I'll start on one side. I've got one lap. Lateral high knees down and back, and then I'll load into the hips a little bit more just with a low shuffle down and back once for that as well. And let's do two rounds to warm up. So a lot of horizontal press. So we're gonna start with 6 Spider-Man push-ups. So what you're gonna do is start in your tall plank. As you're dropping your chest to the floor, you're gonna bring one knee forward to the elbow and then push yourself away. Or you can do your push-up and then do your knee drive. You can separate it that way if you need to. The harder version will obviously be to bring one knee forward when you're at the bottom. And then 6 per side, half kneeling halos. So grab your bell. We're gonna have one knee down. That's kind of where the bell's gonna start, like at that hip flexor. Both hands on the bell, you're gonna come up and across the chest, around the back of the head, and then back down to the hip. So good point here is to just pick something in front of you to look at. So you're not moving your head and neck, you're only rotating through the shoulders. So you'll do that 6 per side. And then we'll come on down, hips elevated, single arm chest press. So get your heels digging into the floor, keep those hips up. Arm is gonna come out to about 90 degrees away from the shoulder, press it straight up, control on the way down. As soon as you hit the floor, press it back up again for 6. And then 6 press to sit up. So now we'll just move the goblet to the, move the kettlebell to the goblet position and then press. And then sit all the way up, control back down, and then bring it back into the chest.
Okie dokie. So let's do three rounds of the pressing. Good. Try not to move the head and neck.
Nice, you guys. Three rounds. Okay, so you've heard of run for the hills. We're gonna be doing swing or squat to the hills. So the X there will be your choice. We're basically splitting up each exercise with either 20 swings or 10 jump squats. So you can kind of alternate those. You can decide what works best, but for the swings, just make sure we're doing both hands on the bell. Hips go back and then really pop them forward. Squeeze those glutes, get the hips to full extension at the top. Jump squats, we're gonna try and get those hips in line with the knees and then push through the floor and land softly. Or you can maintain the squat and do pulsing. I'm fine with either. And then first exercise, we're gonna do 10 snatches on the right hand side. So single arm on the bell. Again, getting your hips involved. Creating that pull and push motion. You want to sort of envision zipping up a sweatshirt. You don't want to swing that bell way out in front. You want to keep it relatively close to the midline of the body and get your weight all the way underneath. So 10 there, and then you'll do your swings or squats, and then 10 on the left. And then push press. So we're just using a little bit of momentum from the lower body. Got that weight right at the shoulder. Drop the hips ever so slightly, and then I kind of roll up onto my toes and press straight up and get my body weight underneath that. Then swing your squat, and then we go on to the left, then swing your squat, then no bell. We got 20 jump lunges, that's total, so 10 per side. You can do your switch lunge where you're dropping the back knee, pushing through the floor and switching at the top, or again, you could do pulsing. Stay on one side for 10 and then the other. Then back to swings or squats. And then 10 high pulls on the right.
So we'll kind of do more of that swing high pull motion. So similar to the snatch, you're going to get your hips back, but then we're going to lead with the elbow as you come all the way up to the top of that pull. And then swings or squats, then left side, then swings or squats. And then we're going to do 10 surrender burpees. So what you're going to do is hop down for your full burpee, push up, hop up, and then we're going to go knee to elbow, and then right back into it, hop up, and then knee to elbow. So we're activating some oblique work there. And if you need to separate those movements from push-ups into like a surrender squat, you can too. All right, sounds good. And then, oh, so then if you hit the bottom, then you can choose whether you want to go right back up that direction or you want to start back at the top. You can kind of pick maybe if there's stuff that you prefer to do or want to do, you can do that. Okie dokie. Should be fun, guys. Here we go. Starting with your choice, 20 swings or 10 jump squats. Nice, good job, guys.
Nice job, guys. Almost halfway. Nice, just under 5 minutes. Nice job, 3 minutes exactly. Nice, almost there. Good, 90 seconds, guys. Nice, 45. Nice, keep going, 20 seconds. Nice, you guys. Whew. There it is. Whew.
Thank you.
Welcome. Happy Monday.
You too. Have a good day.
You. Thanks, guys.
Bye.